we are extremely demanding to each other and to our group as musicians, number one. But at the same time, we love the stage as home, and stage as performing podium, and we take a very, very strict care of from the beginning to the end of our performances. Electra is we. It's very important. It's not like she with everybody else. We have to be four. Electra is about being an ensemble of four soloists and with four completely different personalities. Yeah. And we wanted absolutely for sure a female name. We wanted a woman. For us, is something we're proud of.
And it also had to do with, then we started playing around with it, with electricity that were always amplified. With that, it's an extremely female name, strength.
Yeah, electricity was a big part in it. So we absolutely, very strictly spell it with C and not K.
Sometimes I have to function like an instrument, and I have no problem with it because I have an instrument here, right here, and it's just in some pieces you have to use your voice in that way, but in other pieces, like in Marilyn, you step forward and you do your extra thing, and everybody comes at a certain point forward to do this extra little solo if you want to. I'm in a way the storyteller, and yeah, that gives me a little bit bigger role if you want so, but not in all the pieces, it depends really.
It's like combining four completely different instruments. It's on one hand the voice, it's a string instrument, it's a wind instrument, it's a percussion instrument, and to bring these four instruments together, which are really from four such different worlds, it's very tricky for composers, but it's also a big challenge to make it mix. It gives the composer a huge problem. Also the recorder, because it's so soft, or you know, the voice, which can't compete with marimba or whatever. There's loads of problems, but once you find a way around it, you get something new.
We knew these four instruments were essentially out of balance. That's the nature of them. So we threw amplification in. From the very beginning, we worked with a sound engineer. We needed that because you need to bring the recorder up. You need to be able to use effects. We have a lot of electronic effects we use. She's an octave displacement things, distortion machines that would overpower the voice unbelievably if we didn't have that possibility to be amplified. And the composers have to know that. Each composer that writes for us expands the sound, changes the sound, adds to it, takes away from it.
the first pieces we were getting were only basically angel pieces, you know, like three high floating instruments, and I would get to say the text or bow the vibraphone or you know, and we wanted to be, to have the drive we have in our solo careers anyway. So we're becoming a contemporary music band.
When we tour, we have to actually write on the top of a letter, or our manager writes, you must be aware that Elektra resembles a pop band on tour. Also, the fact that we're from four different countries and four different, completely different instrumental worlds. You know, the string world, the wood world.
We bring also like,
actually, I should just call it recorder world. Because yes, that's really a completely weird, apart kind of world. But what it does is it puts in the group, it puts a pool of knowledge that we have that we might take for granted, actually, but that we all know different composers, that we all have different cultural backgrounds, can lead to actually...
And musical backgrounds.
Funny,
not
also funny disagreements because you don't understand each other all the time.
Water Hendrix Marshall. Ritual display, super incised organs.
Cudgels.
1, 2, 3. Under cudgels.
1, 2, 3.
Cyclone sardine. Aspirated banana. Yak splash dog.
The Adam's Fox of Triton.
The sacred fish.
Singer pariah.
To a clitoris.
I believe that we are hoping and trying to make an album that actually people would listen to it and would discover a new world. So each one of the pieces contribute to our ambition to our desire to share what we have been working on all this time on, and how well we have managed to mix. Well, we do like pop music. We exchange pop music ideas, and we actually sometimes before practice do listen to some things also for timing.
But I think it's also, it's got to do with the way we want to work as an ensemble, and we want to play pieces that we all have a good role in, you know, we all want to have a good part in it, you know, we don't want to, you know, always have to sing our top, we all want to be top. And so the composer has to write something that we all like, and I mean, we want to play together because we really like the energy on stage and we want to perform something, and we don't want to hide behind music stands, or we really want to we want to express something, we want to express also femaleism and youth and fun and energy.
Shimmering, sparkling water.
Monica, how is this?
More. More.
Yeah, I know. I personally am allergic to presentations and to music that is only, you have to survive through the score.
Contemporary music is not easy to listen to as well. I mean, we have to admit that. And but it's very interesting. It can be very challenging for public, but you have to maybe introduce it slowly.
As presenters of modern music, we are the ambassador and we have the responsibility to convince the audience and to let them open, you know, their ears before all and their eyes, and to see what's possible.
My dream is to play really great music, and I think with this group, that could happen.
We have still quite a few ideas we still want to develop, and that is only if we have the possibilities to play them, because they're ready to go, to be born.
And I hope to work with, like we have in the past, have these amazing relationships with composers and video artists and other disciplines that make these shows happen, to make them what they are. We can't do it without them.
But basically we have too much to say yet, and it still is a lot possible, especially with these colleagues here.
Yeah.
I think we are really on the right track.